Welcoming back all the students of class 12th political science once again here. As students, you know, we were doing the fifth chapter of our book Contemporary World Politics, and the chapter was Contemporary South Asia. We had already finished up with our three parts in this particular chapter, and the next topic today we are covering is India-Pakistan conflict, and this is one of the most important topic here. And you are much familiar with this particular topic and the conflict between India and Pakistan. So in this particular part, we will be studying the environment of tension, conflict among these two countries. So students, you must be very much aware about the current situation of India and Pakistan, as continuously there is a conflict or the environment of violence all over the border areas of India and Pakistan. So every day in the newspaper or the TV, we see such news every day. So you are aware about it. So it becomes very difficult to maintain peace and decorum in this particular part of the South Asia. So here, in contrast to India and Pakistan, we will be studying the entire problems between these two countries since independence. As the first point, it's written here, it seems that it never will be ended. As we have seen, there has been a lot of tensions and problems between these two countries. Many agreements have been come up. Various leaders have taken initiative to bring things to normal condition. But still, till date, the situations have been as it is. Although there have been certain agreements to improve the relations, but it is still the same. Now, the situation after the partition of India in 1947. So, to understand this particular problem, we'll be starting from the very beginning, that is 1947, when India got independence and the people of Muslim League demanded the separate nation, and there was a partition of India into India and Pakistan. So, the people of the Muslim religion were given a separate country, that is Pakistan. The problem did not solve and settle down here. It moved on further. So what had we, as we know, as we were the colony of the British rule, and as Britishers administration, they had certain states which there were totally controlled under the British, but there were some autonomy given to few states, and those few states were called princely states. There were around 562 princely states under British rule, and few out of them were given, or almost these 562 princely states were given some autonomy and power for their internal matters by the Britishers. So what happened after the partition of India and Pakistan? So in this, we'll be talking about Jammu and Kashmir. As we know, Kashmir was a princely state. So what happened there? As we know, political integration of princely state into Indian central government, 1562 princely states, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, with his diplomatic methods, convinced the rulers of various princely states to accede to Indian except few states. So here, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel played a very important role to consider and convince, with his diplomatic methods, all the members of princely states to merge with Indian central government so that they can become a democratic nation, which was the dream of the first Prime Minister Nehruji. So here the problem arose. So there were around 562 princely states under British rule. But after independence, talking of Kashmir, as Kashmir was a princely state under British rule, and all the princely states were given the option to be aloof from the state, or they can merge with the central government. So here is the problem of Kashmir as a princely state. The king of this particular princely state was Hari Singh, who was a Hindu Raja of entire Kashmir region, who did not wanted to integrate with India or neither with Pakistan. So this Raja Hari Singh, he was a Hindu, and most of the population of Kashmir was Muslim, but he did not wanted to merge with India or with Pakistan. He wanted a separate nation. He did not want to be a part of these two countries, but wanted a separate nation as Kashmir, and he was Hindu. So the problem was here, because Kashmir, the 1947-48 was resulted in the division of provision into Pakistan occupied Kashmir, POK, and Jammu and Kashmir. As we see, Hari Singh did not wanted to merge with any of the countries. Here, Pakistan wanted that Kashmir should be the part of Pakistan, as most of the population living in Kashmir was Muslim. But on the other hand, India said that this particular region of Kashmir was in the territory of India, एंड हरि सिंह डिड नॉट वॉन्टेड टू बी मर्ज विद एनी ऑफ दिस टू बट कश्मीर और द पाकिस्तान अटैक्ड ऑन कश्मीर दैट इज ऑन हरि सिंह एंड हरि सिंह वेंट टू इंडिया फॉर हेल्प एंड बट द इंडिया सेड दे वर अनेबल टू हेल्प हरि सिंह एज दे कुड नॉट एंटर इन द इंटीरियर मैटर्स ऑफ एनी ऑफ द अदर कंट्रीज बट हेयर हरि सिंह साइंड एन एग्रीमेंट विद इंडियन गवर्नमेंट टू मर्ज दिस कश्मीर रीजन विद इंडिया बट पाकिस्तान अटैक्ड ऑन कश्मीर रीजन इन 1947 एंड 48 एंड दिस रिजल्टेड इन टू अ वॉर बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान फॉर कश्मीर दिस इज हेयर कश्मीर 1947 टू 48 दिस सिचुएशन रिजल्टेड इन टू अ वॉर इन टू डिविजन एंड दिस डिवाइडेड दिस कश्मीर रीजन एंड इन टू ऑक्यूपाइड कश्मीर POK एंड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर Here I am trying to show you with the help of the map so that you can have the good understanding of the problem between India and Pakistan and what was the problem of the princely state of Kashmir. So this entire region was the area of Kashmir region which was under Raja Hari Singh but there Pakistan attacked on Hari Singh and this part, green shaded part is called Pakistan occupied Kashmir which was taken over by Pakistan in the war of 1948 and this whitish part is under the control of India which is called Jammu and Kashmir and this red part is Aksai Chin as we have already read in the previous chapter. This is the area where China says it is under China. It is China claims this part comes under China's territory. So from the both side there is a territory conflict in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is the Pakistan occupied Kashmir green part and this is under Indian control. Other map I will show this in the further chapter we will be studying about the war. This is the Kargil. We can say this region LOC. This dotted line is LOC line of control. This is the Kargil region where the war of Kargil took place. And this is the other map showing this plain part is Indian control Jammu and Kashmir. This line with yellow lines is the area Pakistan occupied. This is dotted line is line of control. And this is shaded part is China, Aksai Chin, where China claims to be its part. And this is the Indian controlled part, this part. So I'm repeating this point as you have seen in the map. So after watching the map, it must have become very much clear that Pakistan attacked on Kashmir where Raja Hari Singh was the Raja at that particular time and Pakistan took over some part of the Kashmir at that particular time and it is called Pakistan occupied Kashmir. Okay, that's why it's written in 48 resulted into the division of province is Kashmir. It was divided into Pakistan occupied Kashmir and Indian part was called Jammu and Kashmir. Now moving forward, so the next conflict between India and Pakistan was the war of 1967, which is much popular about it. After the war of 1965, where Pakistan again tried to enter the boundaries or cross the border of India, that is LOC. And after the war, Tashkent Agreement, this is an important agreement which was signed between India and Pakistan in 1966. It was a peace agreement to bring peace in both of the countries. In this, mediator was the Soviet Union, which helped these two to solve the problem. But still, the problem is not solved. But there was a agreement, Tashkent Agreement in 1966 after the war of 1965. And the next war between India and Pakistan was in 1971, which we have already studied. India fought for Bangladesh, where Bangladesh people got asked for the help of Indian government in terms of military and economy so that they can get the freedom from the Western Pakistan, as Western Pakistan always dominated their rules, regulation, customs and culture on East Pakistan, where in East Pakistan most of the people were Bengali and the people are forced here to follow Islam and learn the Urdu language. But here there was a popular struggle and movements against Western dominance, and with the help of India, this East Pakistan was later on called as Bangladesh as they become the independent nation with the help of India. So in this particular moment, there was a war between Western Pakistan and India. So 1971. So, and the next war was in 1999. It is called Kargil War. I've shown that area in the map just now. The Kargil War again on the LOC. So here again, Pakistan military or the militants together tried and crossed the Kargil area, Kargil district of this Kashmir region. Here again, Indian Army came into action, and again Pakistan was defeated here in Kargil War also. The cause of war was the infiltration. Here the Pakistani irregulars and soldiers were infiltrated in the areas of Indian boundaries and positions and Indian side of LOC. So this was in 1999. So we can easily say from these particular points that since independence there has been always a conflict and tension between India and Pakistan relating to the border areas of Jammu and Kashmir. Here as we saw in 1948 there was a war in for the boundary region, then again in 1965, again then in 1999. Although in 1971 there was a war between India and Pakistan that was for freedom of Bangladesh. Moving forward now, in 1998, other than wars, India conducted nuclear tests in Pokhran. Here, India became a nuclear power country. So, as in competition to it, in 1999, Pakistan also conducted nuclear tests in Chagai Hills in Balochistan. It wanted to be a competitor, and in terms of arm and ammunition, it wanted to be as equal as India, so it also got nuclear tests. India and Pakistan also in conflict due to the Siachen Glacier. So there is a Siachen Glacier. It is highest battlefield in the world. Its location is of great importance to India as well as Pakistan. So if any of the countries, Pakistan captures Siachen Glacier, it will be very easy for Pakistan to meet its boundary with China. So India keeps an eye on this particular region so that there is a barrier between Pakistan and China. So this place, Siachen Glacier, has a geographical importance of geographical location. Next, which is a problem between India and Pakistan, which is the most important in today's world, is terrorism. Where all over the world, this is the problem for most of the developed and developing countries. And Pakistan has long been accused for supporting terrorism, as all over the world we know. And India always accused this Pakistan for supporting terrorism in Kashmir and other regions. So in regions of Kashmir, there are a lot of militant groups, terrorist groups. They get lot of military, economy and training support from Pakistan. So they are accused for it. Indian government blames Pakistan government for using strategy of violence by helping us. So here Indian government is blaming the Pakistan government or the Pakistan that it always helps the militant groups and they support them, Kashmiri militants, in terms of arms, training, economy, that is money, and protection to carry out terrorist strikes. That is why with the help of Pakistan government, these terrorists have striked India many times and other parts of the world. And the next problem in this particular situation and topic, India and Pakistan, is Indus Water Treaty. So there was also a conflict between India and Pakistan in relation to the water sharing. There has been a dispute over the river water sharing between India and Pakistan until 1960. Because in 1960, before 1960, there was a conflict for Indus River water. But after 1960, there was a agreement signed between India and Pakistan with the help of, as the mediator was World Bank, under World Bank, agreement was signed between these two countries. This was called Indus Water Treaty, which survives. It survives today also. They follow it. Although there is still a military conflict that is still going on between India and Pakistan on the LOC region, and many terrorist groups are still striking and attacking India, but this policy or this treaty is still working. So these controversial issues which we can see between India and Pakistan, major one is Kashmir. Since 1947, after the partition of India, still this region has not been solved. Still there is a problem. Run of Kutch, this is a region in Gujarat where Pakistan claims that this region also comes under the territory of Pakistan because there is a material called uranium is found here, which is very economically very beneficial for the growth of a country. And the river water, as we have already seen, Indus river water was the problem between these two countries. And ideology, that is, I told you, Vichardhara, there is a total difference between the ideology of India and Pakistan. So these are the problems between India and Pakistan. There were the major three wars of 1948, 1965, 1971 and 1999. Although there is a conflict in the border regions, every day we see in the newspaper or in the television, but major wars have been these four till date, and the problem of Kashmir has still not been solved, and I think it will take a lot of initiative to bring peace and decorum to this particular regions of South Asia. So in this topic, I shall be giving you some questions to do. Till then, you can note down these important points. Thank you.